हेलो फ्रेंड्स, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। वेलकम टू माय चैनल आई बी ऑल डिजाइनिंग डेवलपर। माय नेम इज इंशाल बेग। आई एम अ फुल स्टैक डेवलपर एंड ग्राफिक डिजाइनर। लाइक इन प्रीवियस प्रोजेक्ट वी विल लर्न दैट हाउ टू बिल्ड वन लॉगिन फॉर्म विद एचटीएमएल एंड सीएसएस एंड आई होप यू ऑल एंजॉयड दैट प्रोजेक्ट। नाउ इन दिस प्रोजेक्ट वी विल लर्न दैट हाउ टू बिल्ड वन ग्रिड रिस्पॉन्सिव वेबसाइट लेआउट विद HTML and CSS and I hope you will also enjoy this project like you are enjoying my previous project of HTML and CSS. So, let's start! Now, first of all, we have to just open our text editor, okay? Like previously, we are working with our brackets text editor, so I will just open that, okay? So, over here, I have just opened my brackets text editor. So, here you can see, I have just created two file which is called gridnew.html and gridnew.css, okay? And I have just already linked my also style sheet over here, okay? So just over here you can see I have also written this font family and font weight over here, okay? So just my font family should be of inter, okay? So this is new font over here, okay? And it is really good font for any small grid, okay? So you can also do that like that, okay? So just I will save, and now here you can see I have just created, and here I have also created and link my style sheet, okay? And over here I will just start to coding, okay? So first of all I have to just make two tags, okay? So first of all you have to make the tag which is called nav, okay? And in this nav you have to write nav bar, okay? So I will just not make the nav bar, we will make grid, okay? So just I am writing the names of different, okay? So I will just write over here main, okay? So here I have written nav, okay? So over here I will write main, and now in this main tag I will write main, okay? So just I have just written like that, and over here I will just write div tags, and now in this div tag I will just write id, okay? So I will just write the id of sidebar, and I will also write over here sidebar, and I will just do one thing, I will copy this and I will just paste that, okay, many times, and over here I will just change its name, okay? So I will just change it to like content one, and over here I will write also content one, but c should be capital. So in my id there is not c capital, okay, because just it will not good look, okay? So it will be not good, it will be not good over here. So I will just paste that over here, and I will just paste that over here also, okay? So it will be just, we have to change its figure also, okay? So just I will change it to 2, and over here I will just change it to 3, okay? So over here I have just do like that, and I will just change it to 2, and over here also 3, okay? So here I have just do like that over here, and over here I will do one thing, like I will just write footer, okay? So I will just write footer, and in this footer I will also write footer tag. This is not footer, I am just writing footer, okay? And in this footer tag I have written footer, and over here I will just click to left preview so we can check like how it is looking, okay? So over here it will be random text. If I show here, you can see now it is random text over here. If I show you here, you can see nav bar, main, sidebar, content one, content two, content three, and footer, okay? So these all are simple text. So I will just take it to small, okay, because I don't want it bigger. So I will just change its font size to 12 pixel. So I will just do 12 pixel. So I will just change it to 12 pixel, and over here I will just save. And now if I show you, so here you can see just it is looking good over here, okay, like that, okay? So I will just minimize from here, and I will do one thing, I will just come over here and I will just write over here one thing, okay? So now I will write dot container, okay? So over here you will be asking like we have not make any class of container, okay? So I will show you how to do. Just come over here and I will just write over here div, okay? And I will just write dot container, which is my class which I have made it. So over here I will just do like that, and I will copy this div, and I will just paste that in the end, okay? Because this container class will be containing all the nav bar, main tags, and everything which should be we are styling in our CSS sheet, okay? So over here I will just do one thing, I will just write this brackets, curly brackets which are called, and in this curly brackets I will just write over here like, first of all I have to write one thing which is called like height, okay? So the height should be, I want 100 VH, and over here I will also want one thing which is called display, okay? So I want like display should be like grid, okay? It should be not inline block, okay? So I am just writing grid, and over here I called one thing which is called grid template, because we are making one grid in website layout, so here we have to just use grid tag many times over here, okay? So over here I will write grid template columns, okay? And in this I will write 1 FR, okay? So this 1 FR I will just write 4 times, okay? So this means like you are having 1 FR space over here, okay? Like you write 1 pixel, 1 VH, 1%, okay? So like that there is 1 FR also, okay? So just we will write it for space, and over here I will write grid dash template, and now like over here I have just given the space from the column 1 fr and over here I will just write rows. So I will just define like how much space I want from my rows. So I will write 0.5 fr and I will write 1.2 fr, 1.5 fr and over here I will write 0.8 fr. So now if I show you, so hit save and now if I show you, so here you can see just I am getting spaces, okay, here you can see many spaces are from here, okay. So over here I will minimize and now I will just write over here grid gap. So I will write grid gap should be 0.2 rem, okay. Here you don't have to write pixel percent, we have to just only write 0.2 rem, okay. So there, this is different thing from these all like pixel and percent and from fr or vh over here. And over here I will also write one thing, which should be text align center, okay. Like you all know this is really easy tag, this mean like your text should be in center over here, okay. So I will just save and now here you can see my text has been in center over here and we are also getting our grid gap from 0.2 rem, okay. So it will be not showing like that when we are making grid, so there will be just space of just 0.2 rem, so it will be, you can see that grid grab from there, okay. So over here I have just defined my container class and now over here I will just define dot and now just you have to go to grid.html and over here I will just show you like, first of all here you have to come over here and over here you have to write like grid and now in this grid I will write grid template areas, okay. So here I have just written this grid template areas because in this grid template areas you have to define your areas from where you have to get spaces, which we have just written over in the top, okay. So I will just write nav, then I will just write 4 times this nav, okay. And over here I will just write sidebar, okay. So here you have to don't write that, write over here sidebar and over here you have to write 3 times main, okay. And now in here I will write sidebar again and now over here I will just write one thing which is called like nav, okay. So I will write first of all footer, okay. So I will write footer and footer, okay. So I will just write it and over here I will do one thing like I will just come over here and I will write sidebar and I will write content one, okay, because I want space from everywhere, okay. So I will just write content two and I will write over here content three. So I will just write like that and I will just write this sign to close it, okay. So over here I have just get spaces from here and now if I show you, so here you can see just it is looking like that. So now over here I will just come over here and I will do one thing like I will just come over here and here 0.2 1.5, okay. So here we have to write 0.2 and over here I will write 1.5 and 1.2 over here, okay. So now here we have just done our work till over here, okay. So now here you can see just we have written these all things over here and over here I will just save, okay. And over here I will just come over here and I will just define like dot. First of all I will just not write dot, I will just only write nav, okay. And in this nav I will just write like come over here and now in here you have to write background, okay. In this background you have to write your color which you have to write, okay. So I will just write random colors over here, I will write over here like aqua and now here you have to also define one thing which is called grid area and now here you have to just write over here in this grid area your nav only which you are defining, okay. So I will just do that for all of them. So I will just copy this and I will just paste that many times, okay. So over here I will just change it, so I will just change it to main, okay, because when we are written the main, when we have written nav, so second was our main. So I will just define the background color of main, so I will just write red, okay, and I will just change it to main because we have just written nav top of them, okay. And over here I will just write the class of slider, okay. This was not class, it was like hashtags because it was id, so I will write sidebar which was our id and over here I will just change its color and I will just change it to blue, okay. And I will just do like that and over here I will just change it to sidebar, okay, like I have telling you. And over here I will just change it to like hashtag content one, okay. And over here I will just change its color also, which should be green, okay. And over here I will just change it to content one because I want content one over here because I have just written this. So I will just do like I will copy this, so I will just have to change its figure, okay, and color. So I will just change its figure to 2, then over here 3, and over here you have to just also write 2, okay. So you have to just take care of the id name, you have to just write your id name correctly, okay. If you write just wrong id name, so it should be really problem for you, okay, and it should be not working for you over here. And over here I will also change its color, so I will just change it to yellow. And over here I will just change this color, okay, and I will just change it to like come over here and just write over here crimson, okay. So now if I save and show you, so here you can see just it is having many different color over here. Here you can see that, okay. But here there is one problem. We have just not written a footer. So I will just come over here and I will do one thing. I will just write over here footer, okay. And now only I will write footer. And now in this footer, I will write over here background. And now in this background, I will just write over here my background color, okay. So background color, I will just want of like, I will just only write the background. First of all, I will write grid area, okay. So I will write grid area. And in this grid area, I will just write over here like grid area should be footer, okay. Because I have just written grid area of everything, okay. So over here, I have just written that. And over here, I will do one thing. I will change its color also, okay. So I will just change it to like dark green, okay. So if I do that, and now if I show you, and I will save and show you. So here you can see, just we are getting everything over here, you can see. But we are not getting our content 3 color, okay. So if I show you, so just you have to do like, you have to just go to your grid new.html. And over here, I have just written the ID. And over here, I have just written content 3 over here, okay. So over here, I have to just do one thing. I will come over here and we have just written hashtag, okay. So here we have just do it correctly, but one problem is coming over here, okay. So I have to just take that over here, okay, the problem which was coming. So I will just save, and now if I show you, so hit refresh. So I will just do one thing. I will just go to grid.html and I will just change it to class, okay. So I will just change it to class, so it should be good for us. So I will just come over here and I will just change it to dot, okay, because now it is transferring to class. So over here, now our content is going down enough, okay. Here you can see over here it is just gone. So I will just minimize over here and I will do one thing. I will just here you can see, then here we have just written content 3, okay. So over here I will do one thing. I will just there is one problem. I have just written m, so I will just write n over here. And now over here I will do like, I will just change it to id again, okay. So just I will change it to id and I will just save. And now I will just change it to hashtag, okay, because it is not correct. So I will just change it to hashtag save. And now if I show you, so here you can see, just it is looking good over here. Here you can see now our content 3 is also coming with our all. Here you can see how it is looking good, okay. But there is one problem. It is not looking responsive, okay. It is looking responsive, but we have to just take responsive like good, okay. So I will just tell you how to do that. So I will just do one thing. I will just come over here and I will just write over here, okay. I will add media and I will add only screen, okay. When you are making any website or anything responsive, so you have to just write like that. If it is responsive randomly, so you don't have to write, okay. But it is not responsive like that, which I want, okay. So I will just make that responsive. So first of all, I have written media only screen. And over here, I will write like this sign and I will write max width. So I will write max width should be 550 pixel, okay. And I will just 550 pixel you have to write, okay. So I will write 550, so spelling is incorrect. 550 pixel I have written. And over here I will just write this curly bracket. In this curly bracket I will write dot container, which is our class of all of things which we have written in that. And over here in this container I will just write over here first of all I will write grid template columns, okay. And now in here I will write one fr only. And over here, I will just come over here and I will write grid template rows, okay. And now in this rows, I will write like 0.2. So first of all, I have to write 0.4 FR. Then I will write 0.4 FR again and I will write 0.2 FR. And now over here, I will write 1.2 FR and 1.5 FR. So I will just write like that. And now if I save and show you, so just you have to close this. And now just save, and if I show you over here, so just you have to do like that. And now here if I just do like that, okay, so just it is not looking, okay, responsive over here. It is just looking like that. So I will minimize that and I will just come over here and I have to just do one thing over here, okay. So just you have to also write like 0.4 and 2.2, okay. And over here I have to write like and now here I have to write 1.4 and over here also, then I have also write 1.4. And now here you have to write like grid areas, okay, like previously we have written. So I will write grid template areas. And now in this areas you have to write like sidebar. So first of all we have to write nav, okay. So I will write nav, then you have to write sidebar, okay. Then you have to write like content 1, okay, so spelling is incorrect. So I will write content 1, then you have to write content 2, then write over here content, okay, so you have to write like that, content 3. And over here you have to write footer, okay, in the last which we have written. So I will add footer over here. So just save. First of all, you have to close that. So I will just do like that. And now if I save and show you, so just come over here and hit refresh from here. Okay. So just if I maximize and just if I do like that over here. Okay. So just it is looking like that over here. I will just minimize from here also. Okay. So just I will do one thing over here. Okay. So just I will do like 1.2 FR 1.2, and I will just change it to 1. So just save, and now just come over here and now just hit refresh. Okay. So just you have to just go to inspect, and now over here I will just do like that. Okay. So it is looking like that over here. I will just come over here, and now over here you can do, you can see it is just looking responsive, but it is not looking really good over here. Okay. So I will just do one thing over here. Okay. So just I will come over here, okay, into the sidebar, and over here I will just write main, okay, because main we have not written over here. Okay, main was the tag after the nav because we have not written that. So here just hit refresh. Now if I inspect and show you, so it is just looking like that. And now over here if I just show you in this screen, okay, so just it is not looking responsive again, okay, because I want like nav should be over here, then main, and then all the thing should be comes, okay. So over here I will just do like that, and now over here I have to do one thing, like I will just go to over here, okay, and then I have to do one thing over here, okay. So just over here I will do one thing, 0.4 FR which we have written, then we if I do like 1.2 FR again, okay. So if I save and now show you, so hit refresh, okay, so just it is not going, okay. So over here I will just change it to 1 FR, then 1.2 FR again, okay. So over here I will just do like that, okay. So now here it is good over here, okay. So just I will do one thing, I will just go over here again, okay. So I will just do one thing over here, okay. So just made screen, okay, and we have also defined our these all things, okay, which we have to define 1 FR, and then we have to, take the mistake over here, okay. So the mistake was coming like we have just written media only screen, okay. So over here I have to write end, okay. So here I have just written the end, okay, because we are writing max width, and behind the max width we have to write end over here. So save, and now if I show you, so here you can see now it is responsive, okay. So now it is good over here, okay. So you can not check it over here, you can only check over here, okay. So here you can see now it is looking responsive, okay. So here you can see we have just made it our website layout of grid, okay. So like that you can make your own website layout of grid in HTML and CSS. I hope you also enjoyed this project like you were enjoying my previous project of HTML and CSS. So just you have to practice these all thing we are working with of HTML and CSS, and I hope you will be also good programmer of HTML and CSS like you are of Python, okay. So I will just meet you in next project. So for today, goodbye.